Hey there, Internet. So I'm at the Vogue Theater here in San Francisco, about to see a documentary all about Jane Goodall's life. It's nominated for the Oscar, and Jane Goodall is here. She's going to be doing a little Q&A. Super excited to see it.
Thank you.
I had a quick question for you. Do you think Planet of the Apes is plausible?
Planet of the Apes isn't plausible, but it's a great movie, this last one. It's got a great story, it's got a very ethical plot, and I liked it a lot.
Very good.
Yes.
Technology over the last 50 years that enabled us now to be able to create that experience.
Wow, that's really cool. What was your...
It's more than that, Brett. It isn't just the advances in technology. It's the way that you dreamed up you presented it as it was, and not doctored and not cut in an editorial way, as you say. But it's as it was, and there's a lot more of my personal life in it. But I'd love to know from this audience, how many of you actually thought, oh gosh, well, she can't be alone, somebody's filming it, because I don't think people think that way. And I mean, I felt I was alone, you know, people know I'm you because you go filming me. But did you think he did everything we could? And he actually died in one of the field staff's arms. He wasn't abandoned by us.
But before that, fairly recently before that, people were saying that animals don't have those sort of feelings, right?
When I got to Cambridge, because Leakey told me I had to get a degree, I was told I'd done everything wrong. I shouldn't have given the chimpanzees names. They should have had numbers. That was science. They couldn't have personality, mind, or emotion. Those were human, aspects. But, of course, I've learned that these erudite professors were wrong when I was a child from my great teacher, who did appear in the film, although his name didn't appear. I got Rusty. I told him to mention Rusty, but he wouldn't. He had got executive control or something like that.
Oh, Hollywood. Speaking of Hollywood, I would love Brian Burke, the producer, along with Brett, to come on up and be here for the last question. Come on up, Brian, come on. Stand up. Get up here.
Brett.
I want to ask Brian how you got involved in this.
There's a reason why I like being behind the camera. I got involved in this. I produced. I was partners with J.J. Abrams at Bad Robots for 15 years, and we had just finished Star Wars: Force Awakens, and we finished the first season at Westworld. And I had a high class problem being burnt out, and I came back and I was like, I'm going to take a break. I'm not going to do anything just for a little while. And in less than a month, I was having lunch with a very old friend of mine named Brett Morgan, and we had gone to junior high school together in Los Angeles and had, we were those crazy guys who had fantasies of being in the film business, and we would take buses to Hollywood and collect movie posters when we were kids, and then we kind of went our several ways after college, and we'd run into each other repeatedly along the last 8 years of our lives, and so right after Star Wars, I said, I'm taking a break, I'm not doing anything. And he was like, do you like documentaries? I go, I love documentaries. I just don't know anything about documentaries. He goes, well, I'm just about to start working on a new one. Maybe we could produce together. And he started talking about what it was. And obviously, Jane and I thought I knew about Jane, but I knew nothing about Jane. And he started talking about the footage, and I started getting chills, which is always a good indication that it's probably something you should get involved in.
Unless it's food poisoning.
Yeah, that's true. The chills continue again. It's still there, 5 miles per hour, and they'll chase you. And James, one of the first things I asked her was, were you not concerned about snakes? She said, oh, no, you see them, she mentions it in the film. I mean, they're everywhere. And and fearlessness.
But that's sort of like Hollywood.
That is a lot like Hollywood. But it extends far beyond just the chimpanzees. It's everywhere she could have stepped or where. It's astonishing that she's here.
I had this crazy feeling that I was meant to be there, so nothing would hurt me. And that sounds absurd, but it didn't hurt me. So I was right.